International paper sizes. A1. A2. A3. A4. A5. A6. A7. And A8. A8.
Breakfast with an architect. So, how is it?
Well, there's no disabled access or toilets. The circulation's a mess. The ceiling's uninspiring. The entrance is like finding a needle in a haystack. And the acoustics, it's like a bat cave.
No, I mean the breakfast.
Oh, the breakfast? That's great. When you're designing stairs, you're not supposed to have more than 16 steps in a row.
A severe accident is more likely to happen on a long single flight of stair, more than 16 steps.
Not only is this dangerous, but some people like myself need to take a break halfway through with a landing.
Where's the best place for your bed in your bedroom?
Well, this is uncomfortable, this is uncomfortable, this is uncomfortable, and this is the best arrangement for the bed, like you see in most hotel rooms.
But the question is, how should your bedroom be designed? Not...
Here's a common mistake I see in multi-story car parks.
And not that. Okay, let's see how high this wall is. Okay, just what I suspected, it's under 1 meter. These wall barriers should be at least 1.1 meter high.
Just because it's a car park, it doesn't mean it shouldn't be safe for humans now, should it? But still, is there something wrong with this floor?
So the height's just over 600 millimeters, which is about 3 feet. Now, I've seen some single steps in my time, but this one, do you think it's safe?
It's not very high, is it?
No one's likely to fall from here, are they? Somebody tell me, please!
There's something missing on this stair?
Oh, it's not that wide, it's only about 3 meters. Nothing wrong with this? It looks perfectly safe to me. I don't need anything to hang on to here.
What do you think? You know what's wrong with this fence?
Okay, so I'll give you some clues. It's not the colour, and it's not the material, and it's not the height either.
This may be a stupid question, but step sizes generally have minimum and maximum requirements.
These are set in place for protection from falling and safety, depending on what type of stair. The minimum going or tread is from 220 to 280 mil, and the maximum riser is from 180 to 220 mil. And of course, every riser and going should be equal size.
However, stairs like this, of course, no rules apply, but...
Is your kitchen designed efficiently?
Ideally, a kitchen should be arranged so that the cooker, sink and fridge are arranged in a triangle close enough together. The distance between each element should be between 1.2 meters and 2.7 meters to reduce wasted steps.
Some kitchens, this may be hard to achieve.
Single steps should never be in or around buildings.
Two or three steps is usually okay, but a single step is generally insufficient to provide visual discrimination of a drop.
Making it a trip hazard.
So please don't ever forget.
Ever wondered exactly where the toilet roll holder should be fixed?
Well, it should be 600 mil off the floor and should be fixed on the side, exactly in line with the toilet pan, to the inside face of the toilet roll holder.
However, there could be issues fixing it. Anyway, I bet you've never...
My favourite pencil is a clutch pencil, which is a cult classic for architects.
It's got a greater advantage over other pencils because you can draw faster and it's good for expressive sketching and designing, especially when used with a thick, soft 4B lead.
It also has a thing at the end to sharpen the lead.
Is this car ramp designed correctly?
Has this ever happened to you?
Car ramps can be steeper than pedestrian ramps and are usually between 1 in 6 and 1 in 10 ratio. This ramp looks around 10 degrees, which is steeper than 1 in 6.
Any car ramp steeper than 1 in 6 requires a transition at the top and at the bottom.
These should be at least 2 meters long to stop vehicles scraping. A two-way straight ramp should be at least 5.5 meters wide. This is close, but the height is really good.
So it looks like the ramp gradient wasn't designed correctly. That's why you get this. Or they didn't plan for enough space. Architects have made architecture far too complex. We need to simplify it and use a language that everyone can understand. As a white guy living in East Africa, here's something that happens to me a lot. So I was on this plane and I sat next to this white guy. He kept talking about where he's from and his country. Then he finally asked me where I'm from. I explained I lived in his country for a bit, but now I live in Tanzania, East Africa.
Oh, Africa, he said. You know what? I've never been interested in going there.
Now this kind of thing puzzles me.
Is this ramp designed correctly?
Building entrances need to be accessible to people with wheels and people with mobility issues. This ramp is nearly 1 meter high, and you should never have a single flight ramp more than half a meter high.
As you can see here, the ramp angle is around 8 degrees.
That means that this ramp is about twice as steep as it should be.
So the slip resistance is good, but you need a 100 high curb on the sides here. So some people could have a hard time using this ramp, and it could be considered unsafe.
Is your balcony safe?
So balcony railings must be 1.1 meter high, unlike stairs and ramps railings, which can be 900 high. Balconies must be 1.1 meter high at least. Also, if the balcony is likely to be used by children, then the railing should be designed in such a way that a 100 millimeter bore can't pass through the railing. Also, there shouldn't really be horizontal rails because children can climb up them. So this balcony is safe for adults, but not really for children.
Architect versus
graphic designer.
I design buildings.
I design brand identities.
I use 3D software.
I use 2D software.
I need a license.
And I don't need a license.
I study too much.
I'm mostly self-taught.
My projects can go on for years.
My projects can go on for weeks.
We both work in design.
You know, people living in apartments always fascinate me. I believe the way people live can be directed a little bit by architecture.
You know, a lot of people get confused between architecture and engineering.
Well, architecture begins where engineering ends. There are no straight lines or sharp corners in nature. Therefore, buildings should not have straight lines or sharp corners. So one of the best things about living in Tanzania is the climate. It averages around 28 degrees here, so it never gets too humid or hot, and it never gets cold either. It never ever gets cold, so it's perfect.
Is this wood? No, it's a type of plastic. Is this wood? No, it's plastic. Is this wood? No, it's cement board. Is this wood? No, it's aluminium. Is this wood? No, it's plastic. Is this wood? No, it's metal. Is this wood? No, it's porcelain.
Look at this, these are everywhere. God is in the detail, look at that. Why would anyone do that? Someone's gonna hurt themselves on that, it's nuts.